Okay, so I'm finishing up the chambermaid. I'm hoping to get that video up soon. And, you know, I'm making the prop and I have to do a few things like make the shaft and the hairpin. And I thought, let me watch one of my old videos. And I knew I mentioned it in the Comet Pepper, but I actually never showed the wire size and all of that stuff. So, you know, a lot of these videos, in addition to trying to help other builders, they're also notes to myself so that later on I can remember what I did, particularly with the indoor building videos. That's kind of why I did them. So what I'm going to do now is make a video that shows exactly how I do the front ends, okay? So here's the first part, and this is a 16th inch wire, all right? And then I get an 1/8 inch brass tube. I drill a 16th hole in it right here. And then I drill a hole. I usually like to use around 0.049 for the front, so I drill that. Then I slip that in, and I slip the hook in. I notch it here, okay? And then I really get it nice and hot with a soldering iron and silver solder the whole thing, all right? So it's like one piece like that. I've been using these for over a decade, and it's never failed. I've never had a problem at all. They're great. Now the big advantage of this is I use these Coupe hooks, which you can get from Starlink Flitetech. You can still get them, they're even smaller now. And you see how that has a hole in the front, so it fits in like this. It fits in, slides in, then you turn it, and you can see it locks in there, okay? So you see there's zero wobble with this. Every modeler has problems with hooks. I've used every hook in the book, believe me, and they all wobble, all right? To some extent, but this is absolutely wobble free, and that's why they do it that way in Coupe and Wake, where they're really serious. But also, when you see my old timers have really nice climbs, it's because it's really true and everything is very true, and that's that. All these little things are very important, okay? So also I can wind outside the plane this way and just hook on, you know, because my winder has a hook like this too. It has a little adapter with the same hook. All right, so that's the first thing you do. Then you got to notch the wire for some of these, and you got to do this with the prop on. So let me show you. Oh yeah, let me mention this is really the whole point, because I didn't remember how I did this, which is the hairpin. Now I've used 0.015 earlier, but I noticed I was looking at my KKAs to, you know, remember how I did this, and I saw there I had a 0.020. So this is 0.020 wire. All right. And I don't do anything fancy. I've made little winding things here. I can grab one. Where you, let me just grab one. You put balls in the wood like this and then have a tube with a tooth on it for the indoor, but you don't need that for the outdoor in this kind of bigger wire. So all I do is I bolt in a 16th, I clamp in some 16th wire into a clamp like that. Then I get the 0.020 wire, and first you gotta make this middle, and you see, it's just like two little wraps. So I'll just put the wire there, and I actually just do it by hand most of the time. I'll just bend it around twice like that. And then get some pliers and flatten it out and do all that stuff, okay? You can also hold one end with a pair of pliers if you want and pull it around that way. That might be easier for some people. Whatever works for you. Now, after you get that middle, then I flatten it out and make sure everything looks good. You want to get the ends in the other way. You see in the other direction there. So all I do is I just put this up against that like that. You need to leave a little extra space, and then just wrap the wire around this way. You know, again, it's just like once or twice, just enough to get it around, okay? So that's all I did. Then what I do is make sure these are nice and flat. I also grind it lightly so that that's nice and flat and get rid of any burrs and anything like that. So that's usually called the hairpin. Now I used the spring for many years, but I think the hairpin is better. And I actually demonstrated in my Comet Pepper, it's a very smooth stop. Maybe I'll demonstrate it again. Now, to put the whole thing together here, here's what you gotta do. So now we got this, okay? And the first thing is to get it into the nose button, which is, this is for the chambermaid. We just get it in there, there you go. I like to put on little brass washers here where the spring goes. You see, there's a little brass washer. I've used Teflon, it doesn't matter. Then you put on the hairpin. Oh, I'm sorry, I'm out of frame. It's hard to pay attention and make this video at the same time. Then I'm going to throw in another little brass washer I had sitting around here. Get that on. Okay, now you want to put this, and this is what, you see, you could just have the prop there and it's pushing up against the prop and you got some washers, but I don't like that because there's friction, because there's pressure on the prop. So if you put a little stop like this, then there's no pressure on the prop whatsoever, okay? And this is just an aluminum bearing with a little, you know, pin in it in the middle. And here you can see I got them. Here it says aluminum wheel collar, 2 millimeters. So you look around online, I've gotten them. There they are. Okay, and you can use these to make the front ends too. Now the only thing you got to do with this is make a little notch. You can see it. So the screw sets in there. I've been using these for over a decade. They've never failed once. So you just got to get it over there so that the screw goes in. And don't make that notch deep. If you look at it from the side here, you can probably barely see it. It's very, very shallow. Just a little flat part so that the screw goes in there. And if you want to be sure, you'll know, because if you tighten it up a little and then you move it so it's right over that spot, it'll suddenly get a little bit looser. You go, oh, there you go. And then I can tell that it went in. And again, I've never had these fail. So this way, you see, it's pulling back. And it's not affecting the prop at all. So then, since the prop's on this, I usually like to throw in a couple Teflon washers, which is, I'm gonna do. And then you can stick your good old prop on. Okay, and then finally, you just need the front end. Now this, there's a whole bunch of Freewheels. This is one I got from Valare. So let me show you. And all this does is, it's basically the aluminum bearing there, but it has two holes drilled, so you can make these yourself. And this is a 30-second wire, and this is going to be the pusher and the stop. And then also there's a vertical one, and that keeps this from going back. You see? I'll show you this. So that's the front end. And I usually put, I had it lying around here someplace, but I can skip it for now. I usually put another little piece of brass tubing on there. Okay. And then I put this on. And again, I have a little notch in the front, so you got to locate the notch. There it is. And you want a little space there. You don't want this pressed up against the... Whoops, I'm probably all out of screen. I'm so sorry. You don't want it pressed up against the prop. It's just getting cumbersome to do this. I have the camera in front of me. And then whatever. Then you get that. So let me demonstrate how this whole thing works. All right. So what it does is, when it goes this way, it's pushing up against this wire stop in the prop. Let me move up a little bit. Okay. So when it's... So that's when it's loaded. It's pushing up against that, and of course it's compressed too. And then what happens is, as it decompresses, this is what the hairpin does. I have to put a screw in here, and that's the screw stop. Here, I have it on the KKA, so it'll hit that screw, stop it, and then it'll go into freewheel mode, because this will stop. And you'll see, although it pushes against it in this direction, when it goes the other direction, it just freely, you see, it doesn't stick out as far. And so it just freely goes right past it. That's the freewheel mode. And you can see, it's just, there's nothing. That prop is free to spin. It's an excellent freewheel. There's actually nothing to interfere with it. The rubber, nothing. And that's very, very important. It's very important you get the front end to work really nice. So now we've got this, okay, the hook. And it's very true and a very nice mechanism, very clean freewheel. Now the other thing I like about this is you can totally take it apart at the field. I can take, if the prop breaks, I can take this off and replace the prop. Now the other thing I've had sometimes is the shaft gets bent if I hit a tree or the fence. And then you can take the second one. That's why I like this one. In the old days, what you would do was solder a brass washer there. And you could still do that. That's the same thing. But then you can't remove it at the field. Okay. So I could remove it and put a new shaft in, and we're back in business. All right. If you really don't want to deal with this, then solder a brass washer. And again, that's the same thing. That's how they used to do it in the old days. Okay. So here you go. I've almost got the chamber made done now. I'm going to try to get out and do some flying and get that video up. But hopefully this will help show exactly how the front ends are done. And this is a nice freewheel mechanism. I really like the pins. I used to use springs years back, and I think the springs are good too, but boy, you just get a nice sensitive adjustment with the spring. You should look at my Comet Pepper video and you'll see it. Maybe I'll demonstrate it when I get the chamber made together.